Hello students, today we are going to discuss class 10 science chapter 2, that is acid, bases and salt. So as you have studied in your previous classes that the sour and bitter taste of food are due to acids and bases. In this chapter we will study the reactions of acid and bases and many more interesting things. So all the chemical compounds can be classified on the basis of their properties as acid, bases and salt. So let's start with acids. So what are acids? So acids are the substances that form hydrogen ion when dissolved in water. That means the substances which produce hydrogen ions, they are known as acids. So what are the physical properties of acids? Acids are sour in taste. They turn blue litmus to red. They are corrosive in nature. And acid solution conduct electricity. So what are the different types of acids? So on the basis of origin, acids are divided into organic acids and mineral acids. So what are organic acids? So acids which are obtained from nature, that means from plants and animals. And organic acids are weak acids. For example, we get citric acid from citrus fruits. Lactic acids are found in curd, acetic acid in vinegar, formic acid or methanoic acid in ant sting or bee sting. Second category is mineral acids. The acids which are prepared from minerals. Acids which are prepared from minerals are known as mineral acids and they are very strong acids. For example, hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid and nitric acid. On the basis of the concentration, acids are divided into two categories, dilute acids and concentrated acids. So what is dilute acids? Acids in which the amount of water is more than the acid. That means the acids in which amount of water is more and amount of acid is less. They are known as dilute acid. What about concentrated acids? If the amount of acid is more than water, they are known as concentrated acid. That means here the amount of acid is more and the amount of water is less. So when we are diluting an acid, some precautions are there. So what precautions we are going to take? So we must always add acid to water and not water to acid. So what is the reason, children? This is because when a concentrated acid is added to water for preparing a dilute acid, then heat is evolved gradually and that heat is absorbed by large amount of water to which acid is being added. But if water is added, then large amount of heat is evolved. And this heat changes some of the water to steam. And that can splash the steam, that can splash the acid to a face or clothes and cause acid burn. So now what are bases? So bases are the substances that form hydroxide ions when dissolved in water. That means the substance that produce hydroxide ions in water, they are known as bases. So what are the physical properties? They are bitter in taste. Strong bases are corrosive. Aqueous solution of all bases contain hydroxide ions and they turn red litmus to blue. So what are the different categories of bases? Bases are also of two types, strong bases and weak bases. So what are strong bases? The bases which completely dissociates into its ions in aqueous solution. That means the bases which completely break down in their ions, they are known as strong bases. For example, sodium hydroxide and potassium hydroxide. Another is weak bases. The bases which do not completely dissociate. That means the bases which do not completely break down into their ions in aqueous solution, they are known as weak bases. For example, ammonium hydroxide. Another category is alkali. What is alkali? So alkalis are also base, but which type of base? These are the bases which are soluble in water. So all alkalis are bases, but all bases are not alkalis. So another category is indicators. So how we are going to identify whether the given substance is acid or base? So to identify the given substance, we use indicators. So what are indicators? These are the substances which changes their color or smell in different types of substances. That is, they indicate the acidic or basic nature of the solution by the change in color. That means they change the color. For example, red litmus paper turns blue in base and blue litmus paper turns red in acid. There are many types of indicators. Some are natural indicators, some are synthetic indicators, and one more category is olfactory indicators. So how there is a change in the methyl orange and phenolphthalein, how they change their color. So here one table is given here. We see that methyl orange becomes red in acidic solution and yellow in basic solution. In the same way, phenolphthalein becomes light pink in basic solution and colorless in acidic solution. Litmus becomes red in acids and blue in base. Another is olfactory indicators. So what is olfactory indicator? These are the substances whose smell changes in acidic or basic solution. That means they indicate the presence of acid or base by the change in their smell. Examples are vanilla, onion, clove oil. These are the examples of olfactory indicators. Now we are going to study very interesting properties of acid and base, that is their chemical properties. So the first reaction is reaction of metals with acids. How acid react with metals? So acid react with reactive metals to form hydrogen and salt. So they produce salt and hydrogen gases released. Here we can see the example when magnesium reacts with sulfuric acid, it forms magnesium sulfate and hydrogen gases released. So how we are going to identify the presence of hydrogen gas? So in this is a setup of an reaction. In this activity, we have taken hydrochloric acid and zinc metal. When hydrochloric acid reacts with zinc metal, hydrogen gas and zinc chlorides are formed. So how we are going to test the presence of hydrogen gas? So the gas evolved after reaction of acid and metal can be tested by bringing lighted candle near it. If the gas burns with a pop sound, then it confirms the evolution of hydrogen gas. Burning with pop sound is the characteristics test for the hydrogen gas. Next is reaction of bases with metals. How metals react with base? So base plus metal, they form salt and hydrogen gas. So what is the reaction? When sodium hydroxide reacts with zinc, it forms sodium zincate. When zinc reacts with sodium hydroxide, it forms sodium zincate. This is very, very important reaction, children. And the hydrogen released in this manner is also tested by the same process. Now another reaction is reaction of acid with metal carbonates and metal hydrogen carbonates. So what they form? See the reaction. So acid react with metal and metal hydrogen carbonate to give out salt and hydrogen gas. See the reaction. Acid plus metal carbonate or hydrogen carbonate, it will produce carbon dioxide, salt and water is released. See the reaction. What is the reaction, children? When sodium hydrogen carbonates react with hydrochloric acid, sodium chloride, carbon dioxide and water is produced. So how we are going to test the presence of carbon dioxide gas? How we are going to know that the gas produced is carbon dioxide gas? So carbon dioxide turns lime water milky when passed through it. This is the characteristic test for carbon dioxide gas. Carbon dioxide gas turns lime water milky. What is the reason behind? This is because of the formation of a white precipitate of calcium carbonate. But when excess of carbon dioxide is passed through lime water, milky color of lime water disappears due to formation of calcium hydrogen carbonate. So when excess of carbon dioxide is produced, then milky color of lime water will disappear due to formation of calcium hydrogen carbonate. Next category is reaction between acids and bases. How acid and bases react? The reaction between acid and base to give us salt and water is known as neutralization reaction. So what is one reaction of neutralization reaction? Here we can see when hydrochloric acid reacts with sodium hydroxide, water and salt is formed. Another reaction is reaction of metallic oxide with acid. How metallic oxide react with acids? So we know that metallic oxides are basic in nature. So acid reacts with metallic oxide to form salt and water. See the reaction. What is the reaction? When copper oxide reacts with acid, hydrochloric acid, it forms copper chloride and water is released. In the same way, water is formed when zinc oxide reacts with sulfuric acid, zinc sulfate and water is produced. And the last reaction is reaction of non-metallic oxides with base. So the general reaction between a non-metallic oxide and a base can be written as non-metallic oxide plus base, and it forms salt and water. Since this is similar to reaction between a base and an acid, we can conclude that non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature and metallic oxides are basic in nature.